Christmas card from San Jose Adentro, Dominican Republic. Although it's not Christmas today, this is more or less how we'll be cooking Christmas dinner. On the fogón, a wood fire. Here we're cooking a special Dominican soup, getting ready for the day. And here is Rudy, who is cutting up vegetables, and all kinds of vegetables. ¿Cuál tipo de vegetables usted prepara, Rudy?
Yuca, plátano.
Yuca, plátano, aljama, todo esto. All of these vegetables are going to go in this soup here. And this is going to be just about the same as our Christmas dinner. Here we have people from all different countries. Here's Lulu, a Haitian, and here we have Rudy, Dominican, and me, of course, American. Ah, fresh garlic being crushed right here in this piece of equipment. And all the vegetables that are ready to eat. Over here we have chicken in a pot, getting ready to put in the soup. And here's plátanos, which grow right here on the farm. And our aljama, which is squash. Just a little bit showing you the area right near our house. And plátanos. We grow our own plátanos, or plantains, you call them in the United States, right here on the mission property. Here's just a view of the country here where we live. The community water system. Almost every day is wash day. And what better place to dry your clothes than just hanging on a rope or barbed wire along the side of the road. Everywhere, clothes are hanging up, drying in the sun. No dryers here, ladies. The neighbor's house. My assistant, Rebecca, lives here with her husband and five children. And of course, clothes everywhere. Thatched roofs. Here's Rebecca's kitchen. She's not using a wood fire today. They have the money for gas. The gas is expensive here. We use gas. Oh, here's Rebecca cooking lunch. And she's cooking on a little stovetop gas stove. And lots of Latin music in the background. Ah, blender. There's electricity right now. And there isn't always electricity here. So when there's electricity, Rebecca is using her blender. What's the matter, Rebecca? The blender no saving? Ay, ay, ay. A type of soup being made on the stove. Her blender is broken. But use it anyway. That's the back of Rebecca's house. And here we have the shower. And of course, the outlet for the shower, which goes down the hill a little bit and dumps out into my field, which provides nice water for the different vegetables you see growing in the back. This is Rebecca's husband. Everything is kind of laid back in this country. Everybody's just kind of sitting around, enjoying the music. Neighbors get together, sit here a lot. We enjoy sitting together and talking. Many times drinking rum. It's very popular here. This is like in the back or in the yard of Rebecca's house. And what Dominican house would be total or complete without a big pig in the back? Gotta have a pig in the house. And now there's neighbor's house. I have a little sign put on the side. I'll translate it. Jesus is the center of my vida. They have written on here. Of course, that's the theme for Christmas. I mean, holiday. The truth is, this, quote, holiday wouldn't exist if it weren't for the birth, celebrating the birth of Jesus. That's really what the holiday's all about. Take that out of the holiday, and there isn't any holiday. It never would be. So it is Christmas time. Another house right near me, with a big rancho out back. We all have these ranchos because we live outside, more or less, not in the house. kitchen or the side. The road goes down the hill to the rest of the community. Of course, the road is completely dirt. More local gentlemen sitting down having a cup of que beber? Café?
Café.
Café na manhã. And here's my neighbor. This is right across the street from my house. This is Morgan. And he has a wife and a little boy. And across the street is my house, where on the wall of my rancho it says the sun always shines here. This is a reference to Jesus, which is the center of this holiday, Christmas, the birth, celebrating the birth of Jesus. And here's my house, tin roof, cement block walls, clothes in front, of course. It's a warm day, we have to dry those clothes. You notice up on the tin roofs there are these gutters, because all our water comes from rainwater. We collect every drop of water that is possible to collect on every building on the mission. So there's always water. But still we have to go to the river many times. So in January, February to get river water. Trust me, that's not very clean, but it's better than no water. The water leaves the house and is piped into the big storage tank, which we have several on the mission property, to store water, and we keep it here and then pump the water up into a tank that we have. The pedestal has a 300-gallon tank up on top, and that supplies the pressure for the house and the clinic and the dormitories for visitors and the bathrooms for visitors down the bottom part of the mission. Everything is self-sustaining here. No other choices. This is my wife. We just had our 11th anniversary a couple days ago. And down below the big building you see is the clinic. It's amazing that this clinic, American-style clinic, American provisions and equipment, are all down here in the middle of this area where there's absolutely nothing. So these people get incredibly good dental care here, and it's all thanks to the companies and people that help out keeping this foundation working right here in the middle of nowhere in the Dominican Republic. This is Patricia. Hello, Patricia. This is my daughter, Patricia, Dominican daughter. She's going to dental school. She got 2.5 more years in dental school, and hopefully she'll be working in the clinic. She does the teeth cleaning here now. This is Miguel, my Dominican son. He's working here in the community, does whatever he can in agriculture to earn money. And I think maybe he's going to be getting married soon. Not sure. He's got a girlfriend. That's Rebecca's daughter. This is my daughter, Hennessy. She's 7 years old. She'll be 8 in about another month. She's been with us since she was 3. She's watching TV at the moment. She's a little princess of mine. And I have a granddaughter, which is a little over 2, named Josie Bell, which you'll see later. This is a little store we have in the house, so people can get all the things they want, meats and things that they can't get normally here. We keep them frozen. My drinks, milk, soda, everything to maintain Olympia the house. Everything is here in the little Comado so that people can buy their things at a reasonable price in the country area. Like everywhere, gas is expensive. So, to conserve on gas, I use a motorcycle. That's right. This month I'll have my 70th birthday. And this is my pride and joy. When I get on this motorcycle and take a ride, I enjoy every bit of it, riding down the roads on my Yamaha. This is our other vehicle. Try not to use it too much, because although it's gas, oil, or diesel, diesel expensive here. Probably costs over $5 a gallon. We just got new tires for it. But it's a way for us to take the trash out, and when we want to go someplace with the family, we use it. This is one of our 2 1,000-gallon storage tanks that aren't in the ground. And these we use when we have to bring water back from the river because there's been no rain, there's a drought. We bring it back in a small tank on the back of the pickup truck, drain it with a pipe into this and fill this up, and the people in the community and us can come and get river water and clean it in any way we can. Believe me, you don't know what was walking in that river when we collected it. And That's the water we have to use. But, you know, God keeps us safe, and I've never gotten sick from any of this. So thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to have this tank to put the water in. Many of the flowers and potted plants and so forth you grow in the United States and take in the winter just grow wild here all the time. They're always blossoming, really beautiful, really pretty flowers all the time. This one is always blossoming year-round. And many of these trees have flowers on them once or twice a year. You can see more flowers in the back on the other side of the mango tree and the avocado trees here and the guanabana trees, which all grow fruit here year-round. Well, this has been just a little Christmas card showing a bit of our lives here in the Dominican Republic. This is the main street coming down to the mission. We just thank everybody, all the companies and all the individuals who help us here at this mission. Without you, we wouldn't be here and wouldn't be able to keep doing the quality of dentistry we do. Thank each and every one of you, and God bless at this very precious Christmas, a special time of the year. Christmas, the celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ, our Savior.